is Duhamel and Radford rounding out the top three. And Seguin and Bilodeau, the other Canadian pair, they were actually named as alternates. That's because the German pair of Aliona Savchenko and Bruna Musso, who qualified, had to withdraw because of an ankle injury to her. So here are the Canadians. But it was a great start to the season for them, picking up their first ever Grand Prix win. That was a gold at Skate America. But they were fifth at the Cup of Russia. It was enough to name them first alternate. So here they are because of the injury to the German pair.
Side jump, the triple salchow, very nicely landed by both partners. Watch for the unison on the side-by-side spins. Sometimes when they can't see one another in the changes of position, it's very easy to lose each other, and that's something that the judges are looking for when they give out the grade of execution mark on the quality of the element. And one of the things Julianne and Charlie have done is gone back to last year's short program. Nice throw.
You have to go with what your instincts are telling you, because our sport is not so black and white.
No.
It really is about how to sell an idea, an emotion, a movement, a costume, a piece of music. And if the skater themselves doesn't believe in it, then you better go with something they believe in, so at least they'll start the sales process.
And those points you just mentioned are all things that Julianne and Charlie can do in spades, as well as land beautiful throws like the triple loop.
Julianne finds that running edge so well at the end of the throws, doesn't she?
She really does.
Time.
Thank you.
is an ease between them, and their elements are so smooth. Not a lot of dynamite, like explosions, but it's always smooth and steady. It's amazing that he finds any time to train, considering that he probably has an extra job as stunt double for Justin Trudeau.
Don't think he looks like him.
He does.
Another good skate by our Prime Minister.
Julien Seguin and Charlie Bilodeau of Canada at their second Grand Prix final, but a lot of ground needs to be made up there. Sixth after the short program, as you mentioned, Carol, they went back to their short from last season. Didn't feel like they gave it enough, obviously, because she was injured after nationals, so didn't even have a chance to perform it at Worlds. What did you think of their free skate, though?
I agree with Kurt. They're the most, one of the most appealing, if not the most appealing teams on the ice. Their technical work is usually solid. That's very unusual for Charlie. He's usually extremely consistent. And I think when they, you know, have a little bit more mileage under their belt, they didn't expect to be at this competition. They came in as alternates, so perhaps their preparation wasn't quite as polished as it could have been. But I love the way they skate, and I always anticipate their programs with a great deal of joy, because they always make me feel good when they skate.
You can always rely on them to produce a good product. It'll be interesting to see when they're moving forward, what vehicle they choose. Can they change up the dynamic and make something new? Marie-France Dublé on the left.
José Picard on the right.
125.99, their score that will currently have them at the top. But a lot of skaters to go here, so we'll see where the Canadians end up. 186.85, their total at this year's Grand Prix final.
On the ice, representing Canada,
Justin Trudeau, right?